Days after the announcement of mega Chinese investments worth $400 billion in Iran, Tehran has stepped up aggression against the United States. Over the past few days, three Iranian actions have suggested that an emboldened Tehran is going to heighten tensions with the US. Firstly, the Iranian supreme leader has made it clear that Tehran will not negotiate with the US. Secondly, Iran has said that it has detained the head of the US-based quote-unquote terrorist group accused of being involved in the 2008 bombing attack in Shiraz. And thirdly, the Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps have been bombarding a fake dummy of USA's Nimitz-class aircraft carrier in an aggressive message to the US. In a televised address, Iran's Supreme Leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei went high on his anti-America agenda. Insisting on remaining defiant in face of Trump's maximum pressure policy, Khamenei said that Iran would expand its nuclear program and would not negotiate with the US. The Iranian Supreme Leader was addressing his country on the occasion of Eid al-Adha on Friday. He also drew a link between the US presidential polls and the nuclear deal. Khamenei said he, as in Trump, is going to benefit from negotiations. The Iranian Supreme Leader added, "This old man, who is in charge of America, apparently used negotiations with North Korea as propaganda." Ayatollah's comments come a couple of months after Trump urged Iran to negotiate a deal with the US. Trump had said, "Don't wait until after US election to make the big deal." The US president had added, "I'm going to win. You'll make a better deal now." Earlier in 2018, Trump had himself backed out of the nuclear deal with Iran and had reinstated sanctions against the Shia-majority country. Not just the nuclear deal, Ayatollah has also said that Iran would maintain close relations with local militias as its proxies in the region, therefore denying another American demand. Iran has also detained the head of the US-based group, which it accuses of being involved in the 2008 bombing attack in Shiraz, a southern Iran city that killed 14 people and injured 215. The detained Iranian-American has been identified as Jamshed Sharmahad. A statement from the Islamic Republic's intelligence ministry read, "Jamshed Sharmahad, the ringleader of the terrorist Thunder Group, who directed armed and terrorist acts in Iran from America, was arrested following a complicated operation and is now in our agency's powerful hands." Tehran is now also alleging that Sharmahad was planning more terror attacks in Iran. Thirdly, Iran's paramilitary force, the Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps, launched underground ballistic missiles as part of a military exercise that involved blasting a fake dummy of US Nimitz-class aircraft carrier with missiles in sensitive Gulf waters. The military exercise, called Prophet Muhammad 14th, was held near the Strait of Hormuz, a crucial oil choke point that accounts for one-fifth of the global oil output. Two American bases, Al Dhafra Air Base in Abu Dhabi, UAE, and Al Udeid Air Base, Qatar, went on temporary alert after the launch of underground missiles. It has been reported that US officials have said that though no missiles struck the military base, but prudent precautionary measures were taken and personnel were told to take cover for several minutes. Moreover, missiles are said to have landed close enough to the military bases to be a cause of concern. The US Central Command has stated the United States condemns these irresponsible missile launches in the vicinity of a congested maritime shipping lane. Interestingly, Al Dhafra Air Base is where India's five Rafales had stopped for an overnight halt en route their way to the Ambala Air Base from France. Eurasian Times has reported Indian Rafale jets come under attack by Iranian missiles in the UAE. According to Eurasian Times, at least three Iranian missiles landed near the Al Dhafra Air Base in the United Arab Emirates on July 28, where the five Rafale fighter jets were stationed. Iran's actions have pointed to renewed vigor with Chinese backing. The country is weaponizing its geostrategic location near the Strait of Hormuz. It is also refusing to budge on the question of its nuclear program and is also making it clear that it won't stop supporting using proxy militia forces in the region.